In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use Blender and Awesomebump to create this render image in 8 minutes. I'll share the link for Awesomebump and the reference image used in the description below. Let's open a reference image by clicking this button. We can create normal map, height map, specular map and so on, by using Awesomebump, and it's very easy to use. Left click and drag to rotate the preview mesh. We can easily change the image's color and other details like this. To create various maps, we need to put a check mark on the Enable Preview button below, and click Convert at the bottom. That's a normal map on the right side. Let's try changing some of the settings to see how that would improve the normal map. Please feel free to experiment. Once we click the convert button below, we'll get our maps. The preview mesh is showing a grayscale image, because a lot of maps are stacked. We only need to extract and save a couple of the maps manually. We need to save the specular, height, and normal maps. To save them, click the rightmost icon like this, and assign a corresponding name. For example, N for normal. S for specular, and H for height. In Blender, let's create a plane. S, and X, to scale on the X axis. Select the main node, and press Ctrl, Shift, and T, together to add the PBR texture images. To use the Ctrl, Shift, T feature, we need to activate an add-on called the Node Wrangler. If we don't name the files properly, this won't work. Also, please add a word color to the original image to get it imported properly. The base color node is missing the original image. Let's manually import it. There is our mesh with color, normal, specular, and height maps. In order to add more realism, we can add the displace modifier after subdividing the mesh. I have used the usual tab to go to edit mode, right click, and type S method to subdivide the mesh 100 times. The mesh looks much better. Control 1 to subdivide. Right click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. I'll use the sky texture. Let's turn off Use Nodes under Compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.